Welcome in to Wildcat Sports Talk as we are broadcasting live, bringing it to you from the studio on a day where there is happiness in the air and there's also some sadness today as well. As we know, the passing of Coach Joe B. Hall early this morning. And, you know, in lieu of that, we decided, well, first of all, it's the Tennessee game, so we're going to have to do a pregame show regardless, right? And so we're going to open up the phone lines a little bit later to take your phone calls. But, Tim, tell me your thoughts today and kind of how you're feeling, man. Because I know, for me, I'm excited for the Tennessee game, but there is that sadness in the air today.
There sure is, man. I mean, it's a mix of emotions because, you know, we're always looking forward to the Tennessee game, and we're always excited and we're pumped up, you know, and our juices get flowing whenever we play against Tennessee. But with the passing of Coach Joe B. Hall, it's kind of sad. I mean, it's definitely sad, but you know, Joe B., man, is just a true legend. I mean, a true legend. You know, my earliest memories of watching UK basketball, Coach Joe B. Hall was coaching.
Right.
And, man, it's just a true legend. I mean, I've got a story I'll share later with him when, you know, I got to meet him and, you know, sit with him at a high school game, and I'll share that later. But, it's a sad day. But then again, we talked about it pregame, Adam, and we want to just kind of celebrate his life.
You're exactly right. So that's what we are that's what we're going to do. We're going to celebrate today and talk about, you know, some of the good times. And in doing that, we thought, well, who do we know, right? Who do we know? We always do that, you know, with this show. When something happens, we're like, well, who do we know that could talk best about Joe B. Hall? And, of course, our good buddy Roger Harden came to mind, and we reached out. And so we're going to give him a call here in just a few minutes. I'm actually just a minute here to get him on the line and just kind of talk about Coach Hall. And Tim, you know, how cool is that? I mean, I'm just saying, you know, we've talked about this over the last couple of years, but we've been able to build this footprint of you know, connections where we can connect you to the Big Blue like this. We can get you those exclusive things that you're not going to get anywhere else.
That's what we take pride in. That's what this whole show is based around, connecting you to the Big Blue. It don't just sound good. It's what we do.
Yeah, exactly.
And Roger Harden, man, he's one of our favorite all-time guests on this show. Very knowledgeable about the game of basketball. He loves talking about the Cats. He's always a good guest no matter what, but he was gracious enough to take time out today to talk with us, man, about some of his memories about Coach Joe B. Hall. And I couldn't be more excited about it, man. He's it should be a lot of fun getting him on the phone here.
So here's what we're going to do is we're gonna hopefully this will
This is Roger.
How you doing, Roger? This is Adam and Tim with Wildcat Sports Talk. You're on the air. How you doing?
Thank you. Well, I got a heavy heart, but I got a heart that's at peace with Coach's departure today. But I want to thank both of you for giving me the chance to come on and talk to the fans and share our thoughts and gratitude towards Coach Hall. Thank you.
Yeah, well, you know, we really, like I said, you were the first person we thought about. We were like, you know what? What better guy to come on and talk about Joe B. Hall than the guy that was basically his coach on the floor?
Well, I appreciate that. I tell you, Coach Hall, you know, he grew up in Cynthiana, and every year before every season, our first meeting, even before we got to our team goals and things we wanted to accomplish, he would talk about growing up as a young boy in Cynthiana, making a scrapbook of his favorite Kentucky players, and, you know, later on became a Kentucky basketball player, became an assistant to the Grade 8 offer-up, then became a national championship coach for the Big Blue Nation and the greatest tradition in sports. But the thing that, you know, I think set him apart from any of the other coaches that's ever coached at Kentucky was the great reverence and understanding that he had for the relationship between our fans and our basketball program. And he would pass out a poem every year, and he would read it to us, and it was a poem called Little Eyes Upon You, and it talked about the impact and the responsibility that we would have and that he wanted us to have in a positive way on all of our fans, but particularly the young people in our state. And, you know, every year it was tradition after we would get done with our season, every player and coach would go out and fan out across the state of Kentucky, and we would speak at Rotary clubs, we would speak at youth banquets. I remember I was sent to Beattyville, Kentucky one time. There were seven ladies that had a quilting club that requested one of us come up, and he sent me up there and just talked to them and answered questions about, they were all big Kentucky basketball fans, but nobody had access to the basketball program, our fans, like they did when Coach was there. I remember in 84 when we went to the Final Four, we signed about 12,000 basketballs. If you sent a basketball up to the basketball program at that time, he would make sure that you got an autographed basketball. And every day after practice for about an hour, we would just pass, sit in a line and pass the ball from one player to the next. We'd all sign our name, and he would make sure that you got that. So he had great reverence for our fans. He wanted us to interact with our fans, and I don't think anybody understood it like Coach Hall did. Irrespective of the great coaches and great people that we've had as a coach at Kentucky, I think Coach Hall loved Kentucky and our people and was proud of our state and a proud Kentuckian. And I'm so happy I got to play in his era, because it was a wonderful experience.
Roger, man. It's like you said, it's a sad day, but you know, I look at all the legends that we've lost with UK basketball. You know, you got Bill Kiteley and all the legends. I mean, you got Adolph Rupp, you got all the legends. I mean, we've lost so many legends, but it almost feels like with what you just said, Coach Joe B. Hall could be considered the heart of the program.
I don't think there's any doubt. I know through the years, as coaches have come in and gone since he's been there, he's always had a relationship and supported all those coaches however they wanted him to support him. I think the guys that played for him appreciate the high profile that Coach Cal has given him. But I know that behind the scenes, he's had a relationship and was willing to talk to him about the program and what's important. And, you know, I know our fans loved him. He was the most approachable guy. He loved being outside of Lexington. I know a lot of coaches tend to just stay in Lexington, but Coach Hall, nobody loved going fishing, hunting with the common people that were fans of Kentucky throughout the state. I know I've talked to so many people that ran into him over the years, and he would take time and visit with them and sign autographs and call grandmas and grandpas and wish them happy birthday. And a little known thing is that people forget, when Coach Hall coached at Kentucky, that's back when the phone book existed. We didn't have cell phones. And Coach Hall's number was listed in the phone book. And if you wanted to call as a fan and talk to Joe Hall, you could pick the phone up and call him, and he would talk to fans for hours when he was at home. I thought that was the most incredible thing when I found that out when I came to the University of Kentucky. The access that our fans had to not only the players but to him and our program, it was an open door under Coach Joe B. Hall. And I think it's one of the things that our fans have felt. And let's face it, he's the only coach that's, you know, he was born in Kentucky. He didn't want to coach anywhere else. And when he did all of his endorsements throughout the years, he never had a contract. He only did things on a handshake, whether it be with the shoe companies, the uniform companies, the actual contract that he had with the University of Kentucky was on a handshake and an understanding, and they just don't make him like Coach Hall anymore. But he was a great overseer after Coach Rupp left. I know he was Coach Rupp's assistant, and some of us guys were talking the other day, and I know at the time there's always been a question to integration with our African-American brothers, and we counted up, he signed 14 in-state black players to play at the University of Kentucky, and so he really integrated our state racially into the basketball program. He wanted every kid in the state of Kentucky growing up to know that the dream is alive. If you're good enough, regardless of what color you are, you got a scholarship at the University of Kentucky. And I think that he did a wonderful job. Also, obviously in the beginning, he didn't want to play Louisville. He thought that would give them a little bit too much cachet. He lost that battle. But the way that he handled it later in life, having a talk call-in show with Denny, I think he really kept the rivalry alive, but I think he gave it some civility. And just the greatest ambassador of all time, including Coach Rupp, to the state of Kentucky, in my opinion, was Coach Joe B. Hall, and a lifelong friend to every one of us guys that played for him. He showed up at weddings. He showed up when you had your first son, your daughters. He stayed in touch with you. He was our dear friend. He picked the phone up, got us jobs. Can you imagine being a former Kentucky player trying to get a job in the state of Kentucky, and you got Joe B. Hall calling on your behalf? We knew we were always going to get the job. So, they're a friend, and I just can't say enough good things about Coach Hall and the influence that he's had on our life and also on the basketball program that we all love.
Well, you know, I wanted to say this too, Roger. How fitting is it that, you know, on a day like today, we're playing Tennessee, and Big Blue Nation is going to pack out Rupp Arena for probably one of his favorite rivalries that he ever had as a coach. You know,
there's no doubt. There's no doubt. Tennessee, it was well known. We always had trouble under Coach Hall winning at Tennessee, And one of the things, and I'll go ahead and say that it might be a little off color, but it's the way it went down. Whenever we would play in Knoxville, it would be an old Stokely Fieldhouse. And before we'd take the court, he would always say, "Now, boys, you got to realize one thing. Stokely Fieldhouse is the biggest whorehouse in the Southeastern Conference, okay? You're getting ready to get screwed out there, okay? So you have to not react to it, and I don't want anybody reacting to the officiating but me. But you just need to prepare that that's a whorehouse out there."
That is awesome. That is awesome. I told you, Roger Harden brings it every time we talk to him.
And you know what? You know, that today he is smiling down as we get ready to take on Tennessee, and what better way to send him off than in a Tennessee yes. game today at Rupp Arena?
Yes. Well, I felt really good about the game going into it with the way the guys are playing. I think we're really starting to develop and hit on all cylinders. Everybody's finding their role and identity. And I know the way that Coach Kyle felt about Coach Hall. And I don't think there's any chance of the Vols getting a W today in Rupp Arena. It'll be an emotional game. I think Rupp Arena, I think the news of Coach's passing is going to turn the emotion up even more. And I think the guys are going to feel it. And I'm looking for a wonderful victory today for the Kentucky Wildcats as we celebrate Coach's life, but also mourn his passing. But boy, what a life. What a life he had, and what an influence he had on the great state of Kentucky and on thousands of people and fans throughout the years. He is the benchmark of a statesman and a spokesman for the University of Kentucky.
You know what? I couldn't have said it any better. Roger, we really, really appreciate you coming on. You always bring it every time you do. And we hope to hear from you a little more this year. And as I said, you know, today's a big day for Kentucky. And I think there's going to be a lot of happy tears today.
Thank you. I appreciate always the opportunity. Thank you for both for what you do for the basketball program and for the fans. And let's go, Cats. Let's get one today for the great coach, Joby Hall. Thank you, guys.
We love you, Roger. Have a good day.
Thank you.
Love you guys, too. Appreciate it. Appreciate the love.
There you go, man. I'll tell you what, Adam. We say this all the time, but we're like two big kids in a candy store when we're doing Wildcat Sports Talk. I mean, man, that is amazing, man. Like, I've got chills on me right now because that's one of my favorite moments.
But you see, here's the thing. I mean, we all know Kyle. Everybody has seen Kyle. Kyle's been on this show, and he just commented. He goes, just gave me goosebumps. The kid never watched Roger play. I never watched Roger play. And I can tell you.
But you got that picture in your head. You feel like you're a part of it now.
I'm there. And the thing is people, it can't be understated enough. Kentucky is just the best program in all of sports. There's nothing better. There's nothing that's going to ever give you this feeling.
Nope.
We are absolutely connected on all levels, and you're exactly right. I couldn't have said it any better, Tim. Joby Hall was the heart of the program, and we've lost it.
And, you know, I didn't even think about that until we were sitting here listening to Roger.
He's the heart of the program.
Yeah.
And it's sad. It's sad. It really is. But you know
what? We got to keep it going, though. We got to keep that heartbeat going for Joby Hall.
We're
going
to keep it going. There's guys like Roger out there that I think can carry that heartbeat and carry that flame right along.
Oh, yes.
And then past that. For anyone that has thought about going to the game today, if we could, I would leave right now.
Yes, yes.
I'd
run there if it wasn't too far.
It's probably going to be one of the most emotional atmospheres we've had in Rupp Arena.
It's
going
to be amazing, guys. We got to get this win today. Call everybody. Call your mom and them, like we like to say. Tell everybody they got to get behind the Cats today. You got to cheer them on, even if it's from home. And, Adam, I tell you what, man, I challenge anybody out there to bring a better pregame show than we brought today.
Bring it. as a matter of fact, let's keep it rolling. I just opened up the phone lines for you folks out there, 859-428-8419. I want to hear from you. I want to hear what you have to say today. We want to talk to our fans out there and let them call in our show. So 859-428-8419 is the number to call. I'm trying to get this thing adjusted to where I can actually, you know.
You feel better now?
A little bit, but it's still not perfect, and it's not wanting to do exactly
You're just going to have to.
Here we go.
You're just going to have to go with it, bro.
Let's see what that does. Oh, there we go. That's perfect. That is perfect. You are on with Wildcat Sports Talk. Who am I talking to?
There we go. That's perfect.
I'm sorry?
It's feedback. They're getting you delayed.
Are you there?
Yeah.
This
is Kyle.
Do what now?
This is Kyle, yeah.
Hey, what's up, man? How you doing?
This is Kyle.
Turn off your...
I did.
All right. Good deal, Kyle. Hey, man, what'd you think about that? That Roger Harden quick interview.
I mean, you know, I've watched all the big interviews on here, and I've never felt the way I felt about that one, boy.
Yeah. Ooh.
I think he's right. I think we tear the pieces out of Tennessee.
Yeah.
Just because of the emotion, and I can't wait.
Tim, you know that if Tennessee just got that word, that they're going into Rupp Arena going, oh, no.
Yeah. They're like, why today?
Yeah.
Yeah.
They might catch COVID, boys.
That was a good one, Kyle. That was a good one. They're testing right now, going, everybody test.
Test. Let's just get these tests going.
Oh, man, that was a good one, Kyle. Kyle, man, what do you think about, off a little bit from what we've been talking about today, but just talk about the Cats, Kyle, real quick. What do you think about this year's team?
Dude, Tata stepped it up. I mean, he's had to. If not, I don't believe without Tata that, I mean, Oscar's been scoring a lot, but without him being a solid little point guard that he's been the last couple of games, Davion Mintz, he's been everybody's stepping into their role. That was the problem with last year's team. Nobody could do that. And this year, everybody's figuring their role. They're filling it out. They're getting better. They're getting way better. Now, if they can just do that every game, this team will be scary.
Scary good. You're exactly right. I want to get to some other calls, Kyle. But
your prediction, real quick. I'll let you get a prediction, and then we'll let you go.
Yeah, give us your prediction.
86-70.
I like it. Hey,
let's do it.
Go Cats.
Go Cats.
Go.
859-428-8419 is the number to call.
Else can we say?
That story, and I love it. I love it because you know what? He is exactly right. Stories like that, those are the ones that everyone will remember. Those are the ones that's like, yeah, it's a little off color, but do you know that's what that, I mean, that's coaching is off color.
Exactly. And especially when you go back in the day
when you know that, you know, like, how many times have you really gotten real with a player while coaching Tim? Mm-hmm. How many times have you said, now listen, we're getting, I mean, like,
this a lot, every game. But you don't hear about it. You know what I mean? You don't hear that in the media. You don't hear that in the public. But that's what Roger Harden brings when you bring him on the show. He gives you that behind the scenes. I mean, dude, he was telling us about the poem that he gave the players every year. And, you know, I mean, just the stuff that Roger brought us, man, I think Roger put us in a uniform, Adam, and he put us right on the team. We were able to see what it felt like and hear about it. That was amazing, man.
Yeah. Yeah, and you know what? You know, going back to his era in that time, of course, obviously, everyone remembers the Georgetown game. Everyone. Yeah. But even to the point of that, you know, you look at that and you go, man, he had some legendary teams. I mean, just name some of the guys that played. I mean, my goodness, Rex Chapman, Kenny Walker.
I mean, the list goes on and on. Melvin Turpin.
I mean, like, legends, man. And it's just – it's so nice to hear from a guy that was there and you know. But let's go ahead and go to the phone lines again. Who we got?
It's Scott.
Hey, Scott. How you doing, buddy?
Man, I'm holding up. It's holding up as best as we can, considering, you know,
we lost a legend. With you, I wanna actually say this now because I think – you know, I've been sitting here all morning, and I've been thinking a lot about this. And what a lot of people don't know is my grandfather is also 93 years old. He was born in 28. He will be 94 on January the 24th. And my whole entire life, he's talked about Adolph Rupp and Joe B. Hall. He's given me all kinds of memories of those guys that he had. And, you know, I think when Tim said that, you know, Joe B was kind of the heart of the program, he's exactly right. And I think that, you know, with my grandfather telling me these stories over the year, that just echoes that sentiment because my grandfather knows that he's the heart of the program. And I would have had him on the show this morning. I called him this morning and talked to him about it. And, yeah, I mean, he's pretty sad today. But it is a part of life. He lived a good long life, 93 years old. I mean, that's a long time.
Yeah.
And well deserved. Wow, you know, I don't know. I don't want to get too biblical on folks, but people that live that long, there's a reason for that. There's an absolute reason for that.
Yes, sir. I agree with that 100%. Thanks for sharing that. Wow, that's awesome. Man, I don't even know where to go with this. Joe B. Hall played such a big role in my life as a youth because I was such a big Kentucky basketball fan as a child. I'll tell you a funny story because I know other people want to call and get in, and I can go, you know, being in the ministry, I can go all day.
Man,
if you let me. But real quick story about Joe B. Hall. My dad was a U of L graduate. He graduated from the University of Louisville and was a Louisville fan. I was a diehard Kentucky fan. Well, I became a diehard Kentucky fan. One day, my uncle dropped by the house, picked me up, and said, "Hey, I'm going to take the boy out for the afternoon." Well, he took me out to a UK basketball game. Now, it was 1984. We had a great team that year, a great season. It was Kentucky Wildcats versus the Auburn Tigers. I saw Roger Harden. I saw the Twin Powers. I saw Auburn had Chuck Persons. They had Charles Barkley. It was a great basketball game. I remember it vividly, even though I was only about 8 years old when it all happened. So that's how I became a Kentucky fan. Well, that year we get knocked out by Georgetown. We're having an autograph signing up here at the Rooster Run gas station. And my dad, being a diehard Louisville fan now, that's how good of a man my dad was, he said, "All right, I'll take you up here. We'll go see Coach Hall." And it was Coach Hall signing autographs. It was Sam Bowie and Melvin Turpin signing autographs. So Here I am, this little boy, and we pulled in the Rooster Run. And, you know, we're right out here outside of Louisville. We're in Bullitt County, so it was not too far from our house. It was, you know, a 20-minute drive. And I'm not lying, boys, when I tell you this. They were standing in the road. In the road. In that line by the time we got there.
Wow.
So we pulled up in there. And my dad goes, "Son, I love you, but man, we ain't standing in that line." So we go on into the store there, and they had a little table set up, and they're outside on the sidewalk signing autographs. And my dad takes me up to the back of the glass, and right there I got to look at the back of Toby Hall's head and the back of Melvin Turpin and Sam Bowie's head. I got to see them up close. But I didn't get their autographs that day. Unfortunately, I was not waiting that line, and it was every bit of a 2-3 hour line.
Like I said, you got the memory though, Scott.
I totally appreciated my dad taking me, and I wasn't even really upset. I just was so glad to get to see him in person, and then of course I met him later in life, and I got to talk to him and talk to him a little bit about what I wanted to do in life and stuff like that. And he was just so encouraging and just said, "Well, do it then. You know, just go for it. You know, what are you waiting on?" And this was, I was kind of, you know, I was up in life a little bit. I was already had kids and married and stuff. And so I just thought it was just kind of almost like a God wink, you know, just kind of like he just, you know, it was a mentor of mine already. And then I had somebody that I looked up to encouraging me. Wow, man, you talk about a blessing. Well, how awesome was that? Just that, you know, especially when somebody you admire and look up to and they give you that word of encouragement. Well, man, I tell you what, it was a blessing to me. And just I've got other Joby Hall stories I can tell in detail later on, but man, I just we lost a great human being, a great coach, a great Kentuckian. His record speaks for itself. Go look at the numbers. Anybody wants to say anything negative about that, go look what he did. And, I mean, it's numbers don't lie. But I really appreciate you guys giving me the time to talk and to share that. I mean, how do you follow Roger Harden? I'm great with that.
Hey, we appreciate it, Scott.
Roger's awesome, man. But we appreciate you. And we're going to give our predictions and then watch this game today and cheer on our Cats and just, you know, cry some happy tears today. You ready for that?
Yes, sir. Go Big Blue. Let's go. Thank you, guys. Appreciate it.
All right, go Cats.
All right, Tim. You know what I want to do for a change? I really don't even want to give a prediction today.
Well, I got to do something real, real quick. I know we're running out of time, but I said to start this show that I was going to give my story about meeting Joby Hall, and I'm going to make it real short.
Go ahead.
I was at a high school Sweet 16, the Sweet 16 tournament in Rupp Arena, and I was a young sports writer. And I was sitting there, and I was just in awe of where I was at because I was in Rupp Arena. And right beside of me, right to my right side, was Joby Hall. And he was sitting there. Through the whole game, we were talking, chatting. And it got down to a last-second shot, and South Laurel, the team I was covering, called timeout. Joby Hall, without me asking him, looks over at me, and he goes, "You know what I would draw up here?" And I'm sitting here going, "I can't wait to hear it, Coach." You know, and Coach was like, I don't remember the exact play, but he was telling me who to give the ball to and where the play would go. It was the exact play that South Laurel drew up. The shot rimmed out, but South Laurel got the rebound and put it back in and won the game. And I remember looking at him, and I was like, "Coach, you called that play." And he just smiled at me. I mean, that's all he did.
You know, I have a Joby Hall story. And So mine is a little different, but I was at Rupp Arena. I was covering – it was actually the – I want to say well, I can't remember the exact year. It was probably, I want to say 13. It was after the national championship. No, I'm sorry. It was the national championship year. It was in 2012.
Okay.
All right. And, you know, back in that time, people that went to call games, they actually had like a hospitality room in the back for media.
Right, right.
So you go back there, there'd be like pulled pork. There's like real good food, right? And they had tables all set up. So I go and I'm getting through the line and I get all my pulled pork, get all my food. I go sit down at this table, and I'm by myself. And I hear a voice up behind me. It says, "Hey, anyone sitting here?" I said, "No, go ahead, sit down." I look up. It's Kenny Walker, right?
Skywalker, man.
Yeah. So we're sitting there for a second, and, you know, we're kind of just small talk back and forth. Well, then Joe B. Hall comes and sits down at the table.
Wow.
And he's sitting there, and he asked me who I am, and I tell him, you know, I'm with a small radio station down in Southeast Kentucky, and I said, "Coach," I said, what do you think about this year's team?" And he said, "Well," he said, "they're about 90% talent and 10% luck." Now, over the years, I've tried to figure out what that means, right? And I think what we all know of Coach Hall is that, you know, he analyzed everything. He had this. He was probably an X's and O's guy that just all numbers all the time. And I think he realized that team had the talent to go all the way. But he also was letting me know that, you know what, there's a lot of luck in it too.
They had to have that 10% luck, no matter how good they are to win it all.
No matter how they're good they are.
I agree, man.
And I'll never forget that. He is a legend. I'm not going to give a prediction today, but you know what? I'll leave it with this. I hope that today, just for the sake of fun, Cal throws in a 1-3-1 zone just for a few
minutes. That would be so fun. Start the game with it.
Just a 1-3-1 zone.
Even if it's one possession, start the game with it. But, man, this has been a great pregame show. I'm ready for this game, Adam. Great story. I'm sure we'll have many more stories to come. We love you, Coach Hall, and I'll say this to the Wildcats. Let's go win one for Coach.
Let's go win one for Coach Hall. You've been listening to Big Blue Nation's Best Kept Secret. We are Wildcat Sports Talk. I want to remind you folks out there that, you know, this should remind everybody, and I'm feeling really sentimental today, but this should remind everybody that life is what it is. Live it up. Coach Hall did. He had a great life, long life, and is a legend in UK history. But not only that, is just a great man and a great Kentuckian. He loved this state more than anybody could possibly love this state. And that's really what being a fan is all about. So, thank you, Coach Hall. Rest in peace, and you all take care. You've been listening to Big Blue Nation's Best Kept Secret. We are Wildcat Sports Talk. My name's Adam.
My name's Tim.
We're out, y'all. See you later.